Quran chapter 17, verse 9 and 10, lesson 1787. Title is Welfare of the Mankind. Chapter Baniii Israel, the Children of Israel. I seek refuge in God from Satan the outcast, in the name of God, the Beneficent, the Merciful. In the first section of this magnificent chapter, attention has been drawn towards the things which can cause to arrive the mankind up to his ascension of perfection. It has been commanded in it that you should think about power and greatness of your Creator from those things which Allah Almighty has created in the world for improvement of human beings. You should esteem of Him as it is required to regard. Behold, He chose His Messenger, grace, glory, blessings and peace be upon Him, from the human beings and then made Him a pattern of manners, habits, character, behavior, justice, kindness and generosity of mankind forever. He did not keep Him, grace, glory, blessings and peace be upon Him, needy of customary education, religious instruction and experience for teaching Him knowledge of the reality, because for learning these entire things a long duration is required. And when a mankind is prepared by this way, then his remaining life cannot be sufficient that he may show himself as a pattern of good disposition to the people by living among them. Therefore, he, Allah Almighty, solved the problem of time and space, which was required for education and training of the Messenger, grace, glory, blessings and peace be upon him. And within only one night, he showed him wonders of the omnipotence of Allah Almighty in the heavens, the earth and their middling atmosphere, by which his heart was satisfied completely and he believed wholeheartedly that power of Allah Almighty is boundless, and which management of the world has he put in order, that is a surety of mankind's welfare in all respect. He, the Messenger, grace, glory, blessings and peace be upon him, found for the guidance of human beings the chain of prophets, peace be upon them, has been set up by him only, and he has made me with his wisdom and mercy the last ring of that chain. So it is my first duty that I should accept him as incomparable from all others and holder of the most dignified attributes, and I should admit that he is the most eminent and supreme to all limits and space. And he has shown me very great and big signs of his omnipotence by carrying me wonderfully from the square building at Mecca, the inviolable place of worship, to the temple of Jerusalem, and then to the entire heavens. Now I am sure perfectly that he is free from any kind of weakness or loss. After that, it is being reminded to the entire human beings, and particularly the children of Israel, you disobeyed previous prophets, peace be upon them, who were sent particularly for your guidance. It was the reason that you were punished severely. Particularly, at two times, you were nearly finished from the world because of your obstinacy. Now this golden chance is given to you that you should acquire success of the both worlds by following our last messenger Muhammad, grace, glory, blessing and peace be upon him. Urdu mein samaat farmaiye, imaan hai insaan ki behtri. A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajeem. Bis-Millaahir-Rahmaanir-Rahiim. Is azim-ul-shan surat ke pehle rukoo mein un cheezon ki taraf tawajjuh dilayi gayi hai jo insaan ko uske miraj-e-kamal tak pahuncha sakti hai. Isme kaha gaya hai ke Allah azza wa jal ne insaan ki behtri ke liye jo samaan duniya mein paida kiye hain unse uski kudrat aur azmat ka tasavvur karo, uski qadar jaisi karni chahiye karo. Dekho, usne insano hi se rasool sallallahu alaihi wasallam ko chhant kar unko hamesha ke liye insaan ke akhlaq, aadat, chal chalan, bartav, adal, ehsaan aur pyaazi ka namuna bana diya. Haqeeqat ka ilm sikhane ke liye unko rasmi taleem, talqeen aur tajrube ka mohtaj na rakha, kyunki isme ek zamana sarf hota hai aur is tarike se jab insaan taiyar hota hai to uski baki umar uske liye kafi nahi ho sakti ke wo dusron ke andar rehkar unko achhi baaton ka namuna bankar dikhaye. Isliye unki taleem aur tarbiyat ke liye usne zameen, zaman aur makan ka jhagda hi beech mein se uda diya aur ek hi raat mein unko zameen aur aasman aur unki darmiyani faza mein Allah taala ki qudrat ke karishme dikhaye jisse unhe pure yaqeen aur itminan hasil ho gaya ke Allah subhanahu wa taala ki qudrat bepaya hai aur usne alam ka jo intizam kiya hai wo insaan ki behtri ka har tarah zamin hai. Unhe maloom ho gaya ke insaan ki hidayat ke liye rasoolon alaihim assalam ka silsila usi ka qaim kiya hua hai aur mujhe usne apni rehmat aur hikmat se is silsile ki aakhri kadi banaya hai. Isliye mera pehla farz hai ke main use sabse nirali aur ala qudrat wala manu aur iqrar karun ke woh tamam zaman aur maqam ki qaidon se alfa aur ala hai aur usne mujhe ajeeb tareeke ke sath kaaba se baitul muqaddas tak le jaakar aur wahan se tamam aasmanon ki sair kara ke apni qudrat ki badi badi nishaniyan dikha di hain aur mujhe yaqeen ho gaya hai ke woh har nuksan aur kamzori se paak hai. Uske baad tamam insanon ko aur khaas kar bani israel ko yaad dilaya gaya hai ke tumne pichle rasoolon alaihi wasallam ka jinhe khaas tumhari hidayat ke liye bheja gaya tha kehna na maan kar puri puri sazaen bhugti hain. Khaas kar do dafa to tumhari sharaton ke badle tumhe duniya se taqreeban mitaya ja chuka hai. Ab tumhe ye sunahri mauka diya gaya hai ke aakhri rasool Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam ki pairvi karke dono jahan ki sarkhuri hasil karo. صدق الله مولانا العظيم وصدق رسوله النبي الأمي الكريم